Hi everyone. In this video, we're going to be showing two examples of how to calculate cost of goods manufactured and cost of goods sold using T accounts. So here we're given some simple information about our three inventory accounts that a manufacturing company would have, as well as some information on direct labor, overhead, and material purchases. So what we're going to do is just draw our T accounts for our three inventory accounts. So we have materials, we have work in process, and we have finished goods. And I'm just going to label everything that I know. These are all inventory accounts, so I know they're going to carry a normal debit balance. So that's my beginning and ending for each one. And I also know that cost of goods manufactured appears right here and it moves into finished goods. And I also know that once we sell a finished good, it becomes cost of goods sold. I also know that used direct materials go right into process. We also have direct labor and overhead. So all three of our product costs appear in work in process. If we have any purchases, they would go on the debit side of materials, as well as freight in, if we have any freight in. But it doesn't look like in this problem we do, but we have to be cognizant of that. So now I'm just going to fill in the information I'm given. So beginning materials, it tells me in the problem, so the beginning balances are in that column. So beginning materials are $22,000. Beginning work in process, they tell me, is $38,000. And beginning finished goods, they tell me, is $18,000. And they also tell me the ending balances for each one as well. That would be the end of year balances. So for materials, it's $26,000. For work in process, they tell me it's $30,000. And for finished goods, it's $23,000. They also tell me material purchases are $75,000. They tell me direct labor is $82,000. And I also have overhead calculated for me at $39,000. So now I can just figure out what's missing. So if I know that beginning materials is $22,000 and I had purchases of $75,000 and I ended the period with $26,000, I must have used $71,000 in direct materials, which is getting moved directly into work in process. Now remember our discussion about materials, it also encases indirect materials, but we don't really know where that's going as of yet. Eventually it's going to become part of overhead. So for right now, these are all direct materials and they're moving directly into process. So now we have all of our debits in work in process, they're beginning plus all of my product cost, minus an ending work in process of $30,000, I must have cost of goods manufactured of $200,000. Which moves directly into finished goods. Now that I have my beginning finished goods plus cost of goods manufactured less ending finished goods of $23,000, I find cost of goods sold to be $195,000. Okay, so let's take this a step further. If I were to ask you if 975 units were sold, how many did we actually produce? So I'd like for you to push pause on your player right now and see if you can figure out the answer to this question. Okay, if 975 units were sold, how many units were produced? And then once you find the answer, come back and we'll take a look at it together. So the key here is that we know that inventory accounts house the cost of our inventory, the cost of our materials, the cost of our work in process, which includes labor and overhead and materials, and then of course the cost of our finished product. So this number is telling us the cost of what we produced, but we're trying to figure out how many we produced. But we know the cost of what we sold was $195,000, and we know we sold 975 units. So if we take the cost of goods that we sold, which was $195,000, and divide that by the number of units that we sold, we find that each unit cost $200 to produce. If we know that, then we can divide the number of or the cost of what we produced divided by the cost of each unit produced, gives us the number of units that we actually produced. So the total cost of what we produced was $200,000. And we know that each unit cost us $200 to produce. So if we divide the two, we find that we actually produced 1,000 units, but only sold 975. Okay, let's try one more. Here we have Cougar Lamp Manufacturing and provided the following information for the year ended December 31st. So it's very similar to the one we just did. I'm giving you the beginning and ending of your three inventory accounts, but I'm not giving you overhead here. I do give you direct labor, just like we did in the last problem, but I'm giving you a list of other things. And in this problem, you actually have to figure out what counts as overhead and what does not in your calculation of cost of goods manufactured and cost of goods sold. So I'd like you to, again, to push pause on your player, draw your three inventory accounts just like we did before, put all the information that you're given that you know where it goes, put it in the T accounts, and then look at this list of stuff and see if you can come up with what makes up overhead, and then calculate cost of goods manufactured and cost of goods sold. Once you think you've got it, come back and we'll take a look at the answer together. All right, so let's first take a look at what is going to make up overhead before we even get started, because that's going to help us figure out our cost of goods manufactured and cost of goods sold. So we're going to look at this other information right here. So all these things here, we're going to look at these. And what makes up overhead? So remember, overhead is made up of indirect materials, indirect labor, and other overhead. So anything to do with the plant or the factory, that would be included as part of overhead. So the first one is depreciation on the plant, building, and equipment. So we see the word plant, we don't even have to think about it. It is overhead. Okay, so that's one of them. Materials purchases. Well, we know that purchases of materials goes in the materials account, so that's not part of overhead. Insurance on the plant. So again, there's that keyword, we don't have to think about it. That is overhead. Sales, salaries, expense. So this is the selling of the product, not the making of the product or the creating of the product. So this is actually a selling expense, which is a period cost, which is expensed when incurred. So this is not overhead. Repairs on maintenance on the plant. So again, keyword plant, we know it's overhead, don't even have to think about it. Indirect labor, that's one of the main three components of overhead. So indirect materials, indirect labor, and other overhead. So that's definitely overhead. Direct labor is direct labor. And then the last one is administrative expense. Well, anything to do with administration, they don't create a product. That's over there in the admin building, not here in the factory. So that is also a selling and administration expense, which is expensed when incurred. So therefore, it's a period cost, all right? So that is not overhead either. So we have 15,000 plus 20,000 plus 5,000 plus 30,000. So I think that comes out to $70,000 for overhead. So let's look at our 3T accounts now. So you should have found materials used to be $180,000, which moved directly into work in process as direct materials for our purposes right now. But remember, in future, this may be made up of indirect materials as well once we move forward. But for our purposes right now, it's just direct materials moving into work in process. We found our overhead to be $70,000 in the prior screen. That gives us cost of goods manufactured of $405,000 moving directly into finished goods. Then we can solve for our cost of goods sold, and you should have found that to be $402,000. So don't forget about the lecture notes and other videos that you can watch on my website, www.theaccountingdoctor.com. You also might find other helpful information there from prior classes and as well as future classes. There's also accounting games you can play there as well.